Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a dragon's eyeball. No, we're going to do a dragon's eye nail design. We're going to use acrylic to create it, a little bit of paint and all that shebang. So let's get cracking. So I've already prepped this nail, which means I've removed the surface shine and we're all ready to go. I'm going to pop sculpting foam on. I'm just going to check how this sculpting foam fits first. I'm going to pop the tab on the other side. I'm going to give it a wiggle between my thumbs, nice and tight. Don't just go like this. I see people doing this and that really won't do nothing. You've got to really get your thumbs in there. Give it a tight squeeze and roll. Squeeze and roll, squeeze and roll, and squeeze and roll. I'm going to make sure it's nice and tight, so I'm just going to rub my thumbs down the edges, which is going to help tighten everything. So I'm going to dehydrate the nail and we're going to prime. Just this natural nail, you don't need to like cover the finger in it. Two coats. Most of the nail will be done in black, apart from the eye, and the eye is going to come here. I'm going to get a little bit of clear, because I want a nice platform to work on when I create the eye. I'm going to use laser lemon shimmer. Laser lemon. Check that out. It's going to be a bright eye. I'm just going to tease this out, believe it or not, into a lemon shape. Because the eye is kind of the same shape as a lemon. I'm going to use pure black. And I'm going to butt that straight up to the eyeball that we've created. Bring this down to create your length. Same here. So you can write up next to the eye shape that you've created. Keep your cuticle nice and crisp. You don't want to file that away when you come to file. So keep it nice and neat and it'll be a lot easier to file. Just going to put a little bit more on the end. Then we're clear. We're going to give this nail some strength. Then we're going to build in the apex. So I'm always checking the different angles to check that my structure's there. I'm going to pinch that, keep it nice and slim. Right, so we're going to file this now. Now we're all set. I know at the moment it looks quite strange. Purposely done the eye a little bit larger than it actually will be. Right, so now we've filed and created a whole heap of dust on my desk. We're going to buff this. Make it nice and smooth. So I'm going to wipe over with pure acetone just to smooth that out even more. So I'm going to use the emerald chrome now and rub that in to where the eye is. I'm not really bothered about it going anywhere else. Just want to give that eye another dimension. Dust off the excess. Then with Mega Gloss, I'm just going to use that to seal the chrome on the eye. I'm using Mega Gloss because it's thicker and I want something a little bit more raised. And I'm going to tickle over the top of that to keep it quite raised. Pop it in. I'm going to wipe over with acetone to take off the rest of the chrome. We're going to paint the detail onto this eye and then we will dome it again. So I've got some paint here. I've got a dark green, a medium green, and black and white. We're going to add some detail. So I'm just going to edge the eye at the minute. Then I'm going to make a wash. So we're not going to wash my face in it. I'm just going to make a diluted black and start to add some shading around the eye. Now I'm going to get the green, I'm going to make a bit of a wash with that as well. This will start to add some more colour to the eyeball. Right, what we're going to do now is with that green, make it a little bit more intense by adding some more of the paint to it, so it's a little bit darker. But we still want it to flow, so we still need it to be wet. I'm going to use that to just mark out the slit in the eye. So we will do that black, but I'm just marking out the edge for now because what I want to do is create all those little, I don't know what did you call it? It's like a muscle, isn't it, though, your iris? Is that right?
Is it?
I think it's like a muscle because it contracts.
I don't know.
And it's got like little fibres, hasn't it, that sort of come off.
Hey, Siri.
Come on.
Is an iris a muscle?
Okay, I found this on the web for is an iris and muscle. Take a look.
It certainly is.
Well done.
Boom shakalaki.
It's called the iris dilator muscle. The iris dilator muscle, pupil dilator muscle, pupillary dilator, radial muscle of iris, or radiating fibers.
What's the point?
Is the smooth muscle of the eye running radially in the iris and therefore fit as a dilator?
Now you know.
Now we know.
When stimulated, the cells contract, widening the pupil and allowing for more light to pass through.
So I'm just adding little random squiggly lines. Right, we're going to take a bit of white now. Mix it with some water. I'm going to add a little bit of highlight. I'm just going to paint a light spot as if the light is just reflecting. Okay, once that's dry, we're going to get some of the Mega Gloss. Pop that onto the sculpting form. And take a gel brush. And apply that over the eye. And I'm just going to build this up a little bit. Right, pop that in. So I'm going to do a second layer of Mega Gloss. Which will really build up the eye. If you turn that upside down, it will draw the gel downwards and really make it peak up. Right, and then pop me that into the lamp. And then now turn it over. So JJ popped it into the lamp upside down for a few seconds and then turned it over. So you can see how that's raised up now. And because we put on the chrome, you see the kind of effect that you get. Pew, 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 pew. I don't know why it would make that noise. Right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add some detail as if the dragon has got all that. What is it, like a scaly kind of spiky thing around its eye?
Skin.
Skin and flesh. Stop. We're going to do that. Mirror, mirror. A little bit of cat's eye acrylic powder and also sapphire satin, which is one of my faves. I may need a little bit of black as well, so I will have that open. I'm going to use a 3D brush. I'm going to double dip from mirror, mirror to black. And I'm going to start up here. Pat it out. Once it's at that setting point, you can start to pull through with your brush and pat it to create these folds. I'm going to double dip again. I've got a bigger bead this time. once it starts to set, you can start to pull through to get these little peaked sections. I'm just using the very tip now to make this quite sharp. So what I've done in some sections is add a tiny bit of blue. See, all I've done is just picked up a tiny bit of, it's really pigmented this is, just a tiny bit, and then used it like a wash just to add a little bit of colour. All of the 3D work is complete now, so you can see why I did the eye first. Because I wanted to get that all shiny and all nice and domed, and then work the 3D around the eye. It's definitely the easiest way to do it. Just look when it moves. That looks so cool.
That is ridiculous.
Looks real. Because dragons are real. Mm-hmm. Just like unicorns.
And mermaids.
And mermaids. Hey guys, I hope you've enjoyed that. I hope it's been really fulfilling. And I hope it's brought out your inner, what's the film called? Program called?
Game of Thrones.
Is that what it goes like?
Yeah.
Alright, okay. So I hope that's really, you know, brought that out in you. All the products we've used today will be below in the description box. Of course, subscribe and like, give us a thumbs up, and check us out in our next video. See you soon, guys. Bye bye. Okay. I got carrot eye too.
No.
That's a good outtake. Thank you.
Sorry.